There are a number of cheeses lined up on the shelf.
This is Gouda cheese, the most famous Dutch cheese. If you don't cut open the casing, it usually won't go bad. So you can store it at room temperature for quite a while.
So we can eat this?
Most likely.
I'm not hungry at all. I guess it's hard to get hungry in a situation like this. Hey, there's something behind the cheese.
You're right. Why don't we move some of the cheese?
All right, guys. Time to move it. June and I need to look behind you. It's a bottle of oil.
The bottle's old, but we might be able to use the oil inside it for something. Maybe we could put it on the old hag's face. Might help moisturize a little. Get rid of some of those wrinkles.
How about we put a little on your face and then light it on fire?
Maybe I'll use the whetstone to sharpen the knife. The blade of the knife is getting sharper by the second. I should be able to cut something pretty good with this.
So I guess you managed to sharpen the knife, Junpei?
Who are you gonna stab with that?
No one!
You could probably cut something soft with that.
This bolt is rusted in place. It won't budge. Of course! Maybe if I put some oil on it.
Hey!
Just a little bit of oil. And... come on. Come on, you little son of a bitch. Whoa! Ha! Yes! Gotcha, you little bastard!
You did it, Jumpy! You're so smart!
It's cold in here. What is this place?
Are you blind? It's a freezer.
Oh, no way. That's way too cold for me. I'll freeze solid in seconds. Sorry, but I'm afraid I'll have to pass on this one. I'm going to leave the rest to you.
Oh, it's really cold in here.
Hey, you don't need to be in here. You had a fever just a little bit ago. You should stay outside. We got this.
No, I'm fine. My fever's gone now.
But... Ow!
Hey, Lotus! You're out there, right? Open the door!
What do you want? What's going on?
The door won't open. Try opening it from that side, please!
Fine, if you say so. Hold on. It's no use. It won't budge. You've got more people in there. You figure it out.
God damn it.
Anyway, let's find a way out. If we don't get moving, we're gonna be permanent residents.
Two heads are better than none. I'm sure we'll figure something out.
Yeah, you're right. Let's take a good look around this room, okay?
Right. Hey, guys, take a look at this! Ta-da! The knife!
Well, I guess the cold finally got to him.
Jumpy, you're scaring me. There's some frozen meat up there. Looks like pork.
Huh? What's this? It looks like a tag or something. Oh, hey. There's a bag in here. It looks like... dry ice?
Dry ice is just frozen carbon dioxide, right?
Yeah, it is.
I wonder how warm it has to get for it to turn back into gas again.
Hell if I know. How's that gonna help us anyway?
Oh, well. I figured we might be able to use it to get out of here.
Carbon dioxide's sublimation point is negative 109 degrees. Any warmer than that, and it'll turn it to gas. Any lower, and it becomes a solid.
How do you know that?
Despite my looks, I'm the queen... the queen. machine of random knowledge.
Looks bad to mess up when you're showing off. Oh, you're so cold, your mouth's going numb?
Yep, that's right.
You're just doing that on purpose, aren't you? Well, at least she's still feeling good enough to joke around.
Come on, guys. Don't you think that's kind of weird? I wonder why it doesn't turn into a liquid first.
But it can turn into a liquid. Carbon dioxide turns to liquid if you put it under high enough pressure, but at one atmosphere, normal air pressure.
It won't turn into a liquid, right?
That's right. Instead of melting, it'll do what's called sublimating, and change immediately from a solid state to a gaseous one.
See? That is weird. Water's a liquid between 32 degrees and 212 degrees, so why isn't that the case for carbon dioxide?
There's a kind of ice that doesn't turn into liquid when it goes above 32 degrees.
Hmm?
Huh?
I heard about it. Its melting point is 96 degrees.
Ice with a melting point of 96 degrees?
You mean there's water that freezes at 96 degrees?
Yeah. Well, you could also look at it as ice that won't melt until it's 96 degrees.
Water that freezes at 96 degrees? Ice that won't melt until it's 96 degrees. Damn, I'm cold as hell, but I can't ignore this. So, what's this ice with a melting point of 96 degrees called?
I heard it's called Ice 9.
Ice 9?
Originally, Ice 9 was a made-up substance invented by a science fiction author. But recently, scientists have discovered that such a substance actually exists.
Wait, hold up. So, is this thing called Ice 9, or is it water?
Like I said, if the ice is over 96 degrees, it'll be liquid. If it's under that, it'll solidify. So you could think of it as a polymorph of H2O. Here, think of it like diamonds and graphite. They're both made of carbon, right? But depending on the structure of the crystallization, the hardness and the structure are completely different.
So you're saying normal water and this Ice 9 are like that?
Yep. Have you heard the story about the crystallization of glycerin? For 150 years after the discovery of glycerin, people cooled it, warmed it, and did all sorts of things to it. Whatever they did, it never crystallized. However, one day in 1920, some glycerin that was en route to England by ship was discovered to have crystallized during the trip. Naturally, scientists worldwide wanted to research this new crystallized form of glycerin and began asking for samples of the seed. A seed is, of course, a sample of the original crystallized substance. With a seed crystal, further crystallization of glycerin would be a simple matter. However, something very strange happened. Not only did the glycerin encouraged by seed crystals begin to crystallize, nearby samples did as well. It didn't end there. After that day, all glycerin in the world began to crystallize naturally when cooled to less than 64 degrees. Before that day, no matter how glycerin was cooled, it refused to crystallize. But once the crystallization had begun, it was almost like... how do I put it? It was almost like all the glycerin in the world was communicating. Communicating in some way that we can't sense.
Wow, that's pretty interesting. But, what does that have to do with Ice 9?
What she's saying is that it's a lot like Ice 9, what happened. I mean...
a lot like? That would be bad. If water everywhere started freezing at 96 degrees, man...
it'd be the end of the world. At any rate, we're not gonna have to worry about the end of the world unless we can get out of here pretty damn quick.
Yeah, you're right.
Alright, guys. I think that's enough of that. I didn't think we'd get quite this far off topic. I mean, I know I'm kinda at fault here, but we can't be screwing around anymore. Seriously, I might go by the name Santa right now, but I didn't grow up in Iceland. I freaking hate the cold. So let's get cracking, alright? We gotta find a way out of here.